Hello everyone. In the following two videos of this graph theory problem solving series, I will go over my solutions to two problems which involve cycles. This problem is an easy problem taken from code forces round 479 and is rated 1500. And this problem tests your knowledge of a basic property of a cycle, which I will explain. In the next video, I will show you how to find cycles in a graph. So first, let's understand what cycles are. Cycles are a set of nodes in which the number of nodes is greater than or equal to 3, the number of vertices is greater than or equal to 3, and this represents a cycle with 3 vertices. This diagram represents a cycle with 4 vertices, and this graph represents a cycle with 5 vertices. And you can see that in a cycle, the first vertex will be connected to the second vertex, then the second vertex will be connected to the third vertex, and the third vertex will be connected to the first vertex. And similarly, in C4, which is a cycle with 4 vertices, you can verify that this is a graph, and you can verify that this is a graph for C5. And this is basically what a cycle is. So you can check the formal definition of a cycle over here. And an important thing to note is that a cycle doesn't contain any other edges other than the edges in this diagram. So a cycle needs to have exactly n edges. So this is the first property which you can see, that a cycle has exactly n edges. Now the second property which will come to use to us in solving this problem is that every node in a cycle has degree exactly 2, and this means that every node in the cycle has exactly 2 adjacent nodes. Now you should be able to see this property from these three diagrams. You can verify that every node has the adjacent nodes i-1 and i+1. So if you are looking at node I, then you can see that node I has neighbors i-1 and i+1 only, except for node 1 and n, which have neighbors n-1 and 1, or 2 and 10, and you can verify that hence every node has exactly 2 adjacent nodes. And this is the most useful property for solving this problem. So now this problem essentially asks you to find the number of connected components in the given undirected graph, which are cycles. So what we need to do is, we need to explore each connected component and check if it is a cycle, and basically count the number of such connected components which are cycles. And we need to do this in O of n plus m time, which is the time complexity for a normal DFS. So this motivates us to consider a DFS solution to this problem. So let's look at the ideas involved in this solution. What we'll basically do is DFS to explore each connected component of the graph. Now what we need to answer is that for the current connected component, we need to check if it is a cycle. And the key question is, how do we check if a connected component is a cycle? And the answer is simple, based on the second property of a cycle. And what we basically need to do is check that every node in this connected component has degree exactly equal to 2. And that's all that we need to do. So now let's just implement this idea in code. So in the code, first I take in the integers n and m, which represent the number of edges and the number of nodes in the graph. And first I'll have a global variable n which represents the number of nodes, and I have the adjacency list. Then I'll basically read in the graph as the set of edges. And now what I'll do is I'll call the DFS function for each unvisited node. So for that I need to have a visited array, and if the current node is not visited, I'll basically call DFS. Now the DFS function will be a boolean which will return true if the current connected component is a cycle. And the way to do that is we basically need to check if the number of adjacent nodes to U is exactly 2. So if the number of adjacent nodes to U is not exactly 2, we'll return false, because we know that the current connected component won't be a cycle. And what we'll basically do otherwise is, for all the unvisited adjacent nodes, we'll call DFS, and if the DFS returns false, we'll also return false. And then in the end, we'll basically return true because we didn't find any discrepancy. And then we'll basically check if the DFS from I returns true, then we'll increment the answer by 1. And an important thing to note here is that the adjacency list of u.size, so adjacency list of u.size gives the number of adjacent nodes to u. Basically in one step it will give you the number of adjacent nodes to u. And you can easily see that that's true because we know that whenever u and v are adjacent to each other, they are going to get added in the adjacency list of each other. So now that we have accumulated the answer in the answer variable, we'll just print the answer. So let's just run this code on the sample test cases. So I just made one small mistake of not making visited of U1 and putting a not adjacency list instead of an adjacency list. And it passes the first sample test case after I corrected those two mistakes. And it also doesn't pass the second sample test case. So the reason why this doesn't pass the second sample test case is because instead of returning a false value, we should just have a global variable is cycle. And what we should do is that if adjacency list of U is not 2, we should make is cycle false. And we should basically not return anything in this function. We should keep it a void function. And the reason why the code won't work in this way is because the moment we find that the current connected component is not a cycle. So the mistake, I'm just summarizing the mistake which I made. The mistake was to stop exploring the current connected component once we realize that it's not a cycle. And this is actually wrong because we basically stop visiting the current connected component. We count only the nodes we have visited so far in the connected component, and ignore the remaining nodes in this component. And this means if we explore a new node which is part of this component and is unvisited, we will incorrectly consider it to be a new component. So basically what I'm saying is that we'll consider a new component, part of this component, to actually be a part of another connected component. And let me just explain this with the help of a diagram to make it clear what I'm saying. So what I'm saying is that, assume that we started EFS from 1 and we visited nodes 3 and 4. So once we go to 1, we'll actually realize that adjacency list of 1 has a size of 3. This means that we return back from 1 and 2, 3, 4 are unvisited, and this is the thing which is wrong. Like, this situation should not happen. 2, 3, 4 should get visited and basically be counted as a part of one's connected component. And that's what I'm trying to incorporate by basically not returning. So don't return here, but visit all nodes in this connected component. And that's what I'll do by initializing acycle to be false. And over here, what I'll actually do is I'll call it EFS from I. If is cycle, then I'll basically increment the answer by 1. And obviously, I need to set is cycle to be true before, so that the moment, so that we can reset it to false, because then we'll be able to correctly determine if the current connected component is a cycle or not. And this code passes a sample test case, so I'll just submit it to see that it gets accepted. So as you could see, my code got accepted. I hope you like this problem and my solution to this problem. This problem illustrated an important property of a cycle. In the next video, I will show you how to actually find the cycles in a graph. And that problem, which will illustrate the property of finding cycles, is a 2000 problem from a Diff3 contest. So do join me over there. If you like this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up. And do consider subscribing to my channel for more such content. Thank you.